The NBA Twitter scene where I just was, I see that people are very angry, and they're talking about how the NYPD, their crime, jumping on Thabo Sevelash, breaking his leg, then the false prosecution by Cy Vance, who I call one of the dirtiest or the dirtiest DA in the shortest amount of time. And I said that when they offered, the DAADA offered Thabo Sevelash community service for a day, that's called slavery, slave for a day from Cy Vance, the dirty DA, because he didn't commit a crime. The NYPD committed the crime. In my case, I wasn't falsely prosecuted, but the NYPD commit a series of crimes and then Internal Affairs protected them. I went to the CCRB, they forwarded it to Internal Affairs. I went to the NYPD Inspector General, they forwarded it to Internal Affairs. I went to CCPC, Commission to Combat Police Corruption, as part of Department of Investigation, NYC Gov, they forwarded it to Internal Affairs. So guess what? Internal Affairs is super corrupt and I'm suing them and the NYPD yet again. Thabo, I hope you sue them. And your story is a non-story. My story is not a story, not news story either. And Eric Gardner's handwritten lawsuit from how many years ago where the NYPD violated him sexually back in front in public, illegally stopped and frisked him, then violated him, said, "We know who you are, Mr. Gardner. The Parks Department should not employ you. You're a felon." It's worse than that. Eric Gardner handwrote this from Rikers, and he alleged they planted drugs on him. It only got thrown out because he didn't know to update the court, and I wish he had put Ray Kelly's name on that lawsuit. He only put one cop's name. The media is not sharing that. The media has killed that. I've posted it. You can read Eric in his own handwriting. Google Eric Gardner, handwritten lawsuit from 7 years ago. You'll see my blog, New York City, I Love You Big Time. You can click on the link or just start reading. It's Eric in his own handwriting. So Thabo Sevelash's story, not news. My story of being victimized and abused at Dr. Andrew Fagelman's. Google Dr. Fagelman assault. It rhymes with bagel man, but with an F. Google Eric Gardner handwritten lawsuit. How many others are victims of the Manhattan DA, Staten Island DA, Charles Hines? And I'm alleging my guest, Joe Tacopino, jumped in after I was punched, a hole in my retina at the doctor's. And on a Sunday after that, at dinner time, he uses a sock puppet account. I think a friend was sitting there with him. And he said, he called me confrontative cunt. He told me he'd bury me. That's a pretty strong word. Destroy me in court. Very strong. It's witness tampering. It's aggravated harassment. The case was open. I forwarded to the NYPD detectives, who I allege are misogynists. And in my case with Vergona, I asked him, "Are you anti-Semitic?" He wouldn't answer. He was going to false arrest me on Saturday. He yelled, "You're going to drop those charges or I'm going to arrest you." And they let him retire. He wasn't alone. Believe me, it was a gang. When you see Thabo Sevelash hit the ground, there's a gang. It seems like when the NYPD do wrong, it's very, very rarely like one of them. It seems like there's a lot going on when you have these, and the DA's often protecting them, along with every agency that's supposed to police them. I call it passing the corruption buck. So on Twitter, they're talking about it, and maybe CCRB will do what they do when there's a celebrity involved and do the right thing. Otherwise, they are so phony, in my opinion. Unbelievable. Oh, it's just so upsetting. But I'm glad the Twitter world is talking about it. A non-story, no press in New York media about Thabo Sevelash. Where's his apology from the mayor? Why hasn't the mayor and the NYPD commissioner apologized to him? There was no reason to jump on him. No way.